Describe the performance that you put on.
What I do?
Yeah.
Well, most of my songs are fast. Well, whenever I sing, that's what I really mean. Like, I'm singing a song. I don't sing it if I don't mean it.
Speechless, speechless, that's how you make me feel. Though I'm with you, I am far away, and nothing is for real. When I'm with you, I'm lost for words. I don't know what to say. My head's spinning like a carousel, so silently I pray.
So this one's for all the lost children. This one's for all.
What is going on, guys? JD here. Welcome to History in the Mix. And today, as you just saw, is not going to be an easy one. So I did set a few standards for this video. Usually there's a bunch of jump cuts, but today I'm going to edit out as little as possible. I'm just going to talk to you guys about Michael and a bunch of things. So one of my videos that I made and never uploaded was not a story time, because, you know, I'm not Tana Mongeau, but I was just talking about how I discovered Michael Jackson, and the story's actually pretty funny, so I'm going to talk about that, and some other things. So, this is how I discovered Michael. So, I was in this Italian restaurant, it's closed down now, and I was six. This is in 2009, I was six. And I had a Nintendo DS, which is a gaming system for you youngins out there. And I was trying to play this game, I don't remember, and I couldn't hear it because the TVs were so loud, and there's a cut because I just missed that, but it was so loud I couldn't focus. So, you know, being six-year-old me, I just kind of tuned into it a little bit, and someone died. And again, being six, who do they think they are, dying and messing up my DS gameplay? No. And I listened, and I got a name, who died. It was a singer named Michael Jackson. So I asked my mom. I don't remember if this is a direct quote, but something to the tone of, who's this guy, and why is he such a big deal? She said, well, he was a pretty big part of the 80s, 90s, a pretty big part of the 80s and 90s. Like, okay, cool. So at this time, you guys know, I love old stuff. I'm wearing a tie-dye Beatles shirt, Ghostbusters, Back to the Future, etc. But this was before all that, okay? So I didn't watch any of the old stuff, you know? At the time, my big thing was Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. So that is old. I guess it's from the 80s, but I didn't really care that it was from the 80s. So, I was like, okay, can I hear something? And she played me, Beat It. And this was brand new. I didn't really like music at the time. You know, it was okay, but nothing too big for me. And I was like, wow. And she played Thriller and Billie Jean and stuff, and I was blown away. I think it was the music videos for all of them. And just how this guy was so ultimate, you know, and Beat It. They're fighting, he just runs through and dances. I mean, it was awesome. And then I think the next week she surprised me with the Thriller 25 CD, which I know Thriller 25 came out in 2008. I don't remember how she got it. Maybe she ordered it. I don't remember. And I got that. And, you know, I was the fake fan. I listened to Beat It and Thriller and Billie Jean, you know, nothing too cool. And then what really sold me on Michael was the Jackson 5 actually. I don't really listen to the Jackson 5 too much now, but that's really what got me. My favorite song for the longest time was Rockin' Robin, and I don't know why. I like the song. And I liked ABC, because, you know, I'm about that age. Michael was about 6 when he was singing with the Jackson 5. And ABC, I wasn't really big on the Love You Save, but all the, I don't remember what they call it, Gumball Pop or whatever, I was into those songs from the Jackson 5. And then eventually, I just grew tired. So this was in 2009. I really liked Michael into January, February, March, April, May, June of the next year. And then he just kind of faded out. I have a lot of things that I like that just fade out eventually. And then, fast forward to 2015, I'm 12, somewhere in there. I don't remember what the deal was. I was playing on the phone and the internet went out, or I needed music or something. So I go to Pandora, which is an internet radio streaming service. Why am I explaining all this? And I was bored, so I just played the Michael Jackson radio. Because I think I was out of skips for my wrestling radios. Because at this time, you guys know that I fell out of wrestling, but I loved WWE at this time, okay? I was freaking out over it. And I just played Michael. And usually I skip through songs because I'm one of those people that someone passes me the aux cord, I'm skipping the song every minute. I can't listen to a whole song. And I was out of skips, and Dirty Diana played. And that was new, okay? You know, I'm a white kid with a tie-dye Beatles shirt on. I don't really listen to rock, but I'd classify Dirty Diana as rock because it was so terrifically told a story. And I loved it. And I was like, wow, this guy has something. And then I listened to Earth Song. Earth Song, you've heard it if you're watching this video. That song is a masterpiece, okay? And then I started discovering, which a lot of people need to discover, is Thriller. Yeah, it's cool, but History and Invincible and Dangerous, that's where it's at. That is Michael in his prime. People will say Thriller was when Michael was in his prime. Probably at his most famous, yes, but musically, music masterpieces is probably the History era. History through Invincible. Brilliant. So, as I said in my Instagram post, Michael was dead a day before I found out about him. And that sucks. It sucks. God, I wish I could have been there for everything. But I wasn't, and I accept that. You know, if someone came up to me and said, hey, you're going to be alive when you get... You're going to be alive, you're going to see Michael Jackson from Jackson 5, The Jacksons, Thriller, Bad, Dangerous, History, Invincible. Sure, I'd do it in a heartbeat, but I accept that that's never going to happen. And I'm perfectly okay with that. But the thing is, I've never, being as big of a Michael fan as you guys know I am, I said a few videos back that it hasn't really hit me that Michael's dead. You know, everyone can say, yeah, Michael's dead. But Michael means, he's helped me through some tough times. And man, I miss him, but I've never really cried or anything. Because, you know, if you are crying over June 25th and this is when he died, I don't. I can smile. I'm not kind of talking with my head down. He's in a better place. I mean, that's such a cliche to say that they're in better places, but Michael had an awful life, okay? Listen to songs that I include down there. Listen to these songs. I'll include Price of Fame. Price of Fame. I'm not going to cut that out because I said that in the beginning. Price of Fame, Privacy, all these songs. Michael never had love. He couldn't. Everyone just wanted his money. Lisa Marie Presley, Elvis's daughter, just wanted money from him. And that, he never had love. He was bullied for his looks. Everyone called him a freak. The tabloids went ham on him. The poor guy. He never had a normal life. And I think Michael did believe in God. He said that multiple times. he's referencing God a lot with songs like Keep the Faith and Heal the World. And I do believe that, I don't really want to go into religion here, but he is in heaven. He is there. He's good now. Do I want him to come back? No, not really. You know? I know, people are going to hate me for saying that. But you guys have got to get where I'm coming from. He was bullied and everything. Why should someone come back to Earth and get bullied when they're up there and they're good? Maybe they don't have... Maybe that's selfish to say, yeah, Michael should come back and sing. No. Knowing Michael as a person, being up there is better. You know? There's no tabloids. He can sing and dance, but he doesn't have to be Michael Jackson, the most famous band person of all time. I don't really know what Michael is to me. He's taught me a lot of things, you know? Whether it's about peace and love, that's at Beatles. Whether it's about healing the world or making that change. That's why I say make that change. Every video, since I came up with it, every History in the Mix episode, I've always ended with make that change, and I mean that. Because I'm going to get to your guys' comments in a second that you guys left on the Beatles video from last week, which you guys can watch up there. Someone said that, kudos to me for introducing Michael to a new generation, and that's what I'm doing. That's what History in the Mix is about, talking about older stuff, because I'm not one for selfies and whatever else, dabbing, fidget spinners. I'm not into all that. I'm into the Beatles. I'm into peace and love, making that change and all that, and I love that I can talk about that. And I have an outlet where I can voice my opinion. I don't know how many times I've said that, but I've said it quite a bit. Michael died at the age of 50 on this day. I miss him. I miss him quite a bit, but he's better. He's better. I'm not sad. He's better. And I know that he's great. Prince, I guarantee that he watches over Prince, Paris, and Blanket. I'm sure that's something that happens. Side note. I've seen so many memes about Michael calling naming his son Blanket. Blanket's not his real name. That is a nickname. His real name is Prince, like Prince. Throw that out there. He watches over him. Because he is a terrific dad. He could have been a terrific dad. I know he was, but he could have been even better if it wouldn't been for the paparazzi and Conrad Murray. Conrad Murray, screw you. Who else? I'm going to make this a screw you segment. Tom Snedden, screw you. I made a video about that. Why? I think about these all the time. Why can't I come up? Martin Bashir, screw you. All of Lisa Marie Presley, you're okay, but you're almost there. You're almost in the screw you category. You're not, though, because your dad's Elvis, and I can respect that. But I look up to Michael. I do. And if you're a Michael Jackson fan, I know it's hard. I know it's hard to be a Michael Jackson fan because I cannot talk about Michael in front of new people that don't know that I love Michael. And they're like, oh, you know what he did, right? Oh, yeah, I love, for lack of a better term, I love the black Michael Jackson. Oh, yeah, man, I love Thriller. He was in his prime there, but after Thriller, he just became weird. No, I'm internally grateful for Michael. Thank you, God, for making someone as peaceful as Michael. I know Michael, Lennon, Bowie, Mercury, all of these other fantastic artists, Elvis, they're all having a special place in heaven. And I'm sure the music's great up there. So now I'm going to go to your guys' comments. So there's not that many comments because I made the dumb decision of saying, give me your Michael Jackson comments in a Beatles video. So I'm just going to read what I have. And, If you have any that I could include in the video, just write them down in the comments. Just, you know, I probably should have made this a video on its own. First one comes from FBN Gaming and More. Rest in peace, Michael Jackson. Long gone, but not forgotten. You made my childhood, and I was devastated when I heard the news 8 years ago. Shout out to JD for allowing younger kids to get exposed to Michael Jackson through his intro and outro. Thank you, Michael Jackson. Rest in peace. As I said earlier, you know, that's what this is all about. It's just influencing the dabbing, selfie-taking, fidget-spinnering people out there to get with the good culture. And the next and final one, because I told you I put it in a Beatles video, comes from Funkchild3121. Michael, a hero, a legend, but more than that, a wonderful human being. Exactly. Exactly. It truly amazes me how MJ still loved his haters, people who call him a pedophile. MJ was too good for this world, and that I agree with. Totally. Michael with Prince and David Bowie, I Miss You, 1958 through forever. I mean, yeah, forever. I mean, it's been 8 years. You guys have seen this on June 25th, but I'm recording this June 23rd, and I've already seen, like, ABC or something. Not ABC, the song, but ABC News. They're already saying rest in peace, Michael Jackson. And I love it. I miss him. Hey guys, for watching, please like, comment, and subscribe for more next week. How about we make a happy video? Last week we discussed Paul McCartney being dead, and this week we covered an actual death. Hey guys, for watching, please like, comment, and subscribe for more, and remember, today, more than ever,
make that change.
A song for love. L-O-V-E. Yeah.